Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUFU Gaming, and today we are back in Farm Together, and let's just see, I have been playing a good deal here, trying to level up and rack up some funds of different kinds, so I'm currently level 43, and yeah, let's just see what we have unlocked in this time. There is, ooh, nice. Ew, that looks like a Native American set, doesn't it? Ooh, nice. I'm liking this one. Cool. Awesome. Is there any other ones? Nope. Not that is new right now. Ooh, we have a fancy little hat here. It actually goes kind of neatly with this, doesn't it? Is there anything else? No, but there will be down here, as you can see. But I think we can go with this one for now. And let's and change this up a little bit. If we just go for the plain face today, and let's see if we can pick a better one here. Ooh, I kind of like this one. Aha! Did I unlock everything? Yes, in here we unlocked everything, so that is really cool. Look at these. I really like the butterflies, actually. Look at these. Oh, look at the blue one. But not for this. Nope. There we go. I'm gonna have to figure out another set later, where I feel like it fits better with the butterflies. Okay, so emotes. Let's see what's new there. We have, oh, okay, we are excited. And what is this one? A little bit of dancing. Oh, cool. Okay, awesome. And nothing new for the tractor. We have some new pets. Ooh, fancy. Look at this. We have a cute doggy. And then we have this birdie here. Nice. Oh, that is awesome. I love the fact that there's flying ones. Look at this. There's three more. Man, I have to be level 75 before I have unlocked all of these. Okay, still something to work on. So yeah, you don't have a collar. I didn't really think you would have. So let's just try and which one was it we just unlocked, actually? Is it this one? Well, it doesn't really matter, it's just so we can see the new colors. So we have this one, and then we have the little one here with the stars. Very nice. And we have these new things. Didn't we already get this one? I thought we had that one already, but maybe not. There's probably something for my farmer instead. We have a little pig face, and we have an 8-ball. Look at that. Very nice. But let's go with a flying pet. Aha, haven't had one of those before. And then lastly, we have our farmhand, a new look for them. Look at that, nice. Okay, let's stick with that and get into the game, right? Okay, I'm gonna check. Downloadable content, I think it's just the last one they added or something. Does it say there's something new? Is it this one? It's telling me about the Laurel pack. I guess I haven't moused over it. I don't think it's a new pack, is it? Well, maybe it is. I thought the celery pack was the last new one. I haven't actually seen anything about this one. But that looks cool. That's kind of a medieval knight stuff, it looks like. Very nice. Okay, that's good. Now that little exclamation sign removed itself. That is good, because it was kind of in my face every time I felt. So there we go. Ooh, look at us. And with our little birdie. Awesome. Anyway, there isn't really anything new. I don't think I've built anything new at all, because I've mostly just been busy building up some resources. As you can see, I have a little over, well, 2.5 million, which sounds like a lot, but trust me, it isn't, because like some of the animals are like 10k or more to put down. A lot of the flowers are the same, they're really expensive. So, and then of course there's all the crops, but usually the crops, you know, you get all the money back, but the other stuff, you also get all the money back from the other stuff, well, for anything. But, you know, when you do some expansions, like I do out here, for instance, man, I just burned through 1 million in like no time, seriously. Like, sometimes I'm like, oh, I have 1.5 million, and then I put down some new flowers and I'm like, oh, oops, I have no more money. But yes, I have some diamonds, a good amount of ribbons and a whole bunch of tickets, so I'm slowly starting to build up some stuff here. Why do I always do this? That's not what I wanted to do. I know, though, that there is a new donkey that I have unlocked, the Miranda donkey, which you can see is 30k. It's a heavy investment, but of course they do give you money back when you every time when you harvest them. It's 15k every time, and it's not like you have to put it down again. So in that way, animals and flowers and trees are really, really nice, because you just, it's a one-time purchase, and then they keep giving you stuff, unlike crops. But there we go, we filled it out with four different types of donkeys. Look at that, very awesome. And then I was thinking, oh, look at that, I also put down a little bonsai tree over here. I'm not sure if it's where I want it, but that's where it's gonna be for right now. And then I know that well, there's a whole bunch of new stuff, but see, there's even a hay rustic house and a camping trailer and stuff. Little beach chairs, but what I want, oh, here's my new trees, the birch trees, actually. How big are they? Yeah, I figured they would be kind of tall. I have to find a place to decorate with them. But what I wanted here was, I think I want a little pet house somewhere. Where do I want this? I don't think I want it over here, no. I think I do want it somewhere here. Oh yeah, I also put down a little birdhouse there. Well, we could put it here. Look at that. Now we have a little place. Well, not so much for the bird, but when we have a cat and or a dog, they will have a little house here where they can go, right? Very nice. Awesome. So, what else did I have that I wanted to do today? Man. I've been playing for a little bit here, so now I'm a little out of... I've unlocked so many new things in since the last video, actually. But haven't really built any of it. Okay, so as you can see, I have so many cabbages growing here. And that is because I've kind of gotten to the point... where, of course, I still have, there's like three crops here that I have to unlock, and I have to wait until I reach the level. You can see my farm is almost level 46 here. And probably when I harvest all the cabbages, it's gonna level up. But apart from that, I have all of these. So I have started looking at what I need, and you can see I need cabbage level 10. So I planted a whole bunch of cabbages in the hope that I'm gonna reach, well, it is level 10 and we need level 12 to unlock whatever this is. And the same, then I wanted to go for zucchini and all these other ones, depending on which one I can plant at the time when I put them down. Just to try and see if I can unlock all this stuff. So, let's just see if we can actually get the two levels from these capsules. There we go, actually got level 12, so now I should have unlocked a new crop, but let's just fill in here with the zucchinis, and because I need four more levels for those. They have to be level 8 and they're only level 4. It's very low level, so there is a chance. I got two levels from the cabbage from filling out all of this out, so I probably won't get the full four levels from the zucchinis, but I might get close, because it does take more XP for every level. The higher level your crop is, the longer it takes to reach the next level, if that makes sense. And no, I'm not gonna water them, they'll be ready in 13 minutes, so yeah, no hurry with that. Let's go over here and harvest these. And then I actually wanted to see, well, first of all, we unlocked, what was it we got? Ew. Lombardy cabbage. Oh, nice. It's a pretty color. Okay, that is cool. But I think I got a new quest right before I started recording, actually. That required something. Yeah, yellow onion. I don't know if I can plant those at this point. No. That is spring. I could wait for spring, but you know what? You know what? Let's go for some carrots. It don't take too long, so either way I can start planting some yellow onions after this, after I finish recording. Ooh, I kind of... that was actually not what I wanted to do here. Let's, remove you. And Yes. I wanted to remove this and this. And I kind of forgot my little plan here because I'm trying to let this farmhand more or less take care of all the animals and kind of level them up a little bit and work on the animals for the different quests. I don't have that many yet, but I kind of slowly build it up and eventually, you know, you can see I have 8 dogs, 10 pigs for this. We need alpacas and mini rex rabbits. Wow. So we need this guy, which is 5k. Okay, let's put one here. Let's put one over here. There we go. And let's put one there. And then, that's the mini rex. That must be this one. Just a couple to kind of get started. And then I'm gonna put some animals here too, I think. And, oh, I have another area up here actually. So, could. It's really nice you can do this with the tractor too. So, let's just take all 9. There we go. And, was there something else I needed when it comes to animals? There was those 2 off stream. Oh, the belted cows. Yes. What about down here? No. Okay. Belted cows. Jersey cow and Holstein cows. We already have those. Oh, it's this one. They always get put up here when you have a quest for them. You can see there's actually... Oh, I hadn't even noticed that until now. There's this little thing here that actually indicates that you have a quest for them, but they also always get moved up here, at least when you're sorting by availability. You can also sort by the level and stuff, but I usually have it like this. So they are all up here, which is really, really handy. Let's get some cows going, so we can also start working on that quest and level them up a bit at the same time. So let's start with 4. It's 14,000 each, so it is fairly expensive. Put down a couple of these, and we had some more room over there, so I think we're gonna leave some room for some rabbits and this, and maybe another alpaca. There we go. But that's kind of the area that my little farmhand can see. Haha, nice. He'll just take care of that, and you know, he's fishing a little bit here. And well, I used to have some. Well, I do actually. I do have some trees over here that he's also harvesting, and yeah, just doing a little bit of everything, but mainly I prefer that they're just taking care of the animals, because then I don't have to run around and remember to feed them constantly. And of course eventually I'm gonna have many more animals and have them spread more around the farm, or like I said, probably have some out along the edges somehow, but we'll see when we get there. I've also noticed I usually run out of space for vegetables, so I think we need to add something. So far I just have these 3, which kind of almost, you know, take care of it, but once I harvest these entire fields, I usually end up in the max. So, let's actually put down something new. There is the vegetable truck. We had that already unlocked last time, but I didn't have the diamonds for it. We're gonna take this, and for now I think we are just gonna put it let's just put it over here. Not where it's gonna be permanently, but oh, look at this. It's actually also a really, really nice decorative piece. I like that. And it takes 250. So let's see, 250 vegetables, and it increased my storage by 500, and then I get 50 diamonds every time, so that is nice. Always good with more options for diamonds, but it's mostly just that I keep running out of space for it, so and it's easier when you have that many that you just sell once instead of running around to all these, but yeah, it is cool. So what else do we have? Oh, fruit shop. That was the other thing I wanted. And I think for now I'm just gonna pop it down over here somewhere. And because I also... The only reason I'm not full on fruits right now is because I sold a couple. And I was considering putting down another gem stall. I'll probably do that in the near future. Put down another gem stall as well as more fruit presses. Well, actually the fruit presses I need more. to have some more of these, so before I need more gemstones, because these are on a timer, so you have to wait 5 minutes in between each. So I'll probably put down some more of those, but I actually need diamonds more than ribbons at the moment. So I'm thinking I want this, and then of course I am gonna be putting down more of the other stuff later. It's kind of a gradual progress. There we go, and I can already do something, so I'm gonna get 60 diamonds from that. Nice. Okay, oh, can I do it again? Ah, oh, one, oh, and there's no cooldown. Oh, that is awesome. That's almost the best part about it. I do have to remember not to do it all the time, because I do want to also make some gem. But it is nice when I keep filling up, because the more fruit trees I have, yeah, I keep running out. It is, I think, the cheapest way to get ribbons, though, because you can technically just plant down a whole gazillion of apple trees, which is the cheapest tree, and it's ripe every season, so actually every 17 minutes you can harvest all your apple trees. And then you can just go and put them all in the fruit press and generate gem and sell the gem to the gem stall and make a whole bunch of ribbons that way. Because otherwise, honey is one way, but you have to wait 24 hours before you get honey from one of those hives, so it takes a long time. And what else do I get? Oh, right, I almost forgot. There was actually something else I wanted to put down, because I have a new option. For something I can get the ribbons for. So we have the dairy, which turns the milk into cheese, but it only gives us diamonds. But then I actually just unlocked this recently, which is a cheese stand where we can sell the goods and get ribbons. There's also an option for a cheese shop or something, cheese factory actually, which takes milk and milk, and it produces cheese. And of course you get diamonds. So it's kind of an upgraded version of this, which I'm probably gonna get at some point, but I'm not producing enough for it at the moment. But I think we're gonna put this down. Not that I have that much cheese. So I have 11, so I think for now, let's just put it over here. Might end up moving it at some point, but there we go. Now we can get another ribbon. Aha, very nice. Awesome. That was one more thing I had on the list. See, I have a whole bunch of stuff I wanted to do. And then we are gonna head out here to our many flowers that we have out here. And because I didn't even know these buildings were in the game that I'm gonna show you one of now. You have so many flowers I need to harvest. it does take a while, actually, just with what I have, and I haven't even filled out half my, well, not even a third of my, full farm area yet, once I unlock everything, or all the areas. And still, I think it takes at least an hour for me to go through the entire thing in the morning if I haven't played for, 12 hours or something. Because almost everything is ripe, unless, well, except some flowers, because there's actually some flowers here that takes a long time. These Gebera, I don't know how you say it, but these ones, Gebera daisies, yeah, still have almost 4 hours left. They take 7 days to be ripe, so it takes a long time. They're also really, really expensive, which is where a lot of my money went to, because it's 15,000 each, but you do get 45,000 back every time you harvest, but it's only once a week, so yeah, quite the investment. Just this little section here, actually. But yeah, let's see, because there was this new building. Where are they? Right here. See, you can see there's the Arborist's Corner, the Pond Filter System, the Hydroponic Greenhouse, the Cultivation Table, the Feed Mixer, and yeah, I think it's just those five. And the one we are going to look at is the Hydroponic Greenhouse, which increases earnings when harvesting flowers. It's 80 ribbons, so it's pretty expensive. And I have no idea what difference it makes, so we're going to see if we can see that now. And you can get the same, of course, for the fish, for the... This is for the trees, then you have one for the crops, and one for the animals. So apparently these are gonna increase how much we can get. So I was thinking we should try to have something. Where do I want to put this thing? Let's just put it over here somewhere, so... If I can see what this is gonna give me. So 139 each, right? I'm just gonna note a little bit here. And if we just make a little jump here. Boom! So 20 plus 22. And then 1 XP or something. So, haha. Okay. Then let's try and put this thing down. Where are you? Hydroponic greenhouse. Just gonna put you over here, I think, so we can see what it looks like. Oh, okay. That what it looks like. Looked completely different on the picture. Where is it? Well, now it's down here because I can't afford any more of them right now. I wonder if it changes. Where's that yellow thing? Owned one. Okay, you can only have one. That kind of makes sense. But does it change over time or something? Oh, now it says 20 minutes. And is there something about honey? Building not ready. Oh, then maybe we can't test it just yet. Do I have to feed it honey to level it up? Or is it now gonna be doing things? I don't know if it's gonna make a difference. Right now or how that works. So let's just... It did actually change something. I get 142 instead of 139 now for these. 22 XP and one flower. So it seems like we got a little bit extra. I'm not sure if it's worth it. It probably is as you level up. Right now I get 3 gold extra from each. But that's also a lot. You know, considering once I fill all, well, just for this, all the flowers I have there, if I get three extra gold from everything, and eventually when I've filled out the entire thing, then it's gonna make a difference. And of course, if you level up the building, then it's gonna give you even more. I don't know what the deal is with the honey though. If it's just because it's... Either it will level it up every time you give it honey, or it just increases the effect, or the time that it works or something, I don't know. But let's head over here, because I also wanted to buy a new expansion, so that we can expand our flowers. Yep. Ooh, let's see, yes, 3.6, so... Yeah, 3,600. There we go. Ooh, look at this. And yeah, I could technically fill... I'm going to fill all of this in. It's just a matter of not having the room. But I kind of wanted to continue with the concept here. So, first of all, let's just go here. Can I move you? Even though you're ready to harvest, I'm not sure. If it will do it while it is ready to harvest, or if it's gonna cancel the harvest or something. I don't know, we'll see. Actually, I should remove the pink one. Wow. The only thing is you have to... Can I do it with shift? No. You have to like right click every time if you want to remove one of them. Well, it doesn't really matter. Let's see, I can do that afterwards. We need 1, 2, 3, 4. It's because I want this first and then the blue one. So there's 4 here, but I think there's... Isn't there one more? Did I unlock everyone? There's 5 actually, but I have to level up the purple one, which I don't have the purple one yet. So we have 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3. So right here, right? That's where we have the purple. So we have the normal, we have the blue, the pink, and then the purple. And then I might have to move everything again later when I get the last one, which I don't know what color that is, but that's fine. As you can see, it's very easy actually to move things. Like I said, just press set, and then you can go over here and just, you know, plant things as you usually do. So it's really easy to move things. There we go. But now we got the purple hydrangeas, and just checking my list, lavender is the next one we need. Also, I unlocked the saffron crocus. I don't know if you guys remember, I said there was one down here that I didn't know what was, because the other ones I could guess, like this is a type of hydrangea, this is a type of these roses, this is a type of tulip, and so on. And these are kind of, I think, a tea. So the only thing I didn't know was this one, but I don't think I want it over here. I haven't fully decided, but these are really expensive. It's 2 ribbons to buy these. It does give you 102 diamonds as well as a spice to harvest them, but they're pretty expensive. But I think they might end up being over here in this area where I have some of the other ones later on. So the one we have here is the lavender. Where's the lavender? Which one is the lavender? This is the lavender. Ha! So there we go, and leave a gap. So, let's plant some of these. Boom! They don't seem too expensive compared to a lot of the other stuff I have been planting for sure. And then the next one would be lilac. So, which one is the lilac? We have pink wisteria, orchid, common lilac. Okay, so we have a blue and a white. Do we have another one? These ones. So it looks like there's 3 of them. Okay, so we have a common and a white. So we probably want the common one first. Let's just leave another gap. I try to leave gaps in between the different types of flowers, even though it doesn't make it symmetrical in any way or anything, because sometimes there's, you know, then there's 2 gaps almost right after each other, and other times there's like 4 different flowers before there's a gap, but it doesn't really matter. Then let's get the white one, and then that's gonna be it until we can unlock the next section. So, there we go, but you can already see it's 13.5k every time, so my money is really, I'm down to 1.5 million now. So you can see it's quite the investment. Yep, it really is, but it's nice. Okay, 4,220 is what we need, so that's gonna be a little while before I can do that. But yeah, awesome. I'm gonna expand this some more. And of course I need to do a whole bunch of harvesting here. But I think that was kind of all I wanted to show you guys in this one. Just a little bit of all the new stuff, and then I think the next video won't be until I reach level 50, because I wanted to show you guys the train station, which we need level 54. It's one of these down here. Oh no, I think it was actually over here, right? But I wanted to show you guys that one at least. Yeah. So that is it for today, guys. Thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming!